Even amid enormous success, these fixer-upper stars have had some rocky moments. On the surface, their lives look picture-perfect, but behind the scenes, it's a different story. Let's break down the biggest controversies of Chip and Joanna Gaines' career so far. Prior to the success of Fixer Upper, the small Texas town of Waco was mostly known for the fatal 51-day standoff in 1993 between the religious sect known as the Branch Davidians and law enforcement, which ended with 76 members of the cult dead. Chip and Joanna Gaines' Fixer Upper helped breathe new life into Waco's struggling economy, with tourism and business developments booming following the show's premiere. In fact, according to the Waco Tribune Herald, the so-called Magnolia Effect, the term used to describe the ever-sprawling brand's influence on its surroundings, became such a draw that Waco tourism skyrocketed. Along with the town's success, however, came an increase in real estate taxes and housing prices, which left many local residents struggling to buy and keep homes in the once affordable market. According to a 2020 article by the New York Post, home prices and property taxes in Waco rose at a faster rate than the rest of the country between 2017 and 2019. On top of that, one area realtor revealed that approximately 25% of new home buyers purchasing in Waco are from out of state, making it difficult for locals to compete with the rising market.
You know, as long as it can work in Waco, in our backyard, it works for us.
As Fixer Upper continued to climb in the ratings, many fans began flocking to Waco, Texas to get a taste of the small-town charm. Chip and Joanna Gaines began growing their Magnolia Market, which includes a store featuring products made and curated by the couple, as well as a large outdoor space at the foot of the famous Magnolia Silos, where visitors can enjoy food by local vendors. Once again, residents were split on their appreciation for the attention the Gaines brought to their small town. In 2016, neighboring Magnolia Market property owner Darren Farmer sued the Gaines for a figure between $200,000 and $1 million. Farmer alleged that amid negotiations with the Gaines on the purchase of Farmer's property, which was located next to Magnolia Market, the Gaines built a gate that partially blocked access to it, making it impossible for Farmer to use the entirety of his empty lot to make money as a parking lot. The case was dismissed 1 year later after the Gaines reportedly agreed to buy Farmer's property for just under $1 million. In 2021, Chip Gaines' sister, Shannon Braun, clinched a seat as a trustee on the school board in Grapevine, Coleyville, Texas. According to the Dallas Morning News, Braun, who was against teaching critical race theory, received a $1,000 donation from Chip and Joanna Gaines. In a Facebook post on May 26, 2021, Braun wrote, "I'm committed to working alongside our parents and teachers to ensure students get the education they deserve by returning the focus of our curriculum and teaching to academics, rather than filling curriculum with divisive critical race theory training." The Gaines' support for Braun confused fans because it ran counter to previous public messages by the couple, including Joanna's candid admission of the difficulty she faced growing up mixed race in the South in her book, Who You Were Made to Be. In November 2016, BuzzFeed released a damning profile on Jimmy Seibert, the pastor of the Evangelical Antioch Community Church in Texas, which counts the Gaines as members. Seibert, who interviewed the couple on the church's YouTube channel, has taken a firm stance against gay marriage. Chip appeared to address the allegations later that year in a since-deleted blog on the pair's personal website. He wrote, "Joanna and I have personal convictions. We care about you for the simple fact that you are a person, our neighbor on planet Earth. It's not about what color your skin is, how much money you have in the bank, your political affiliation, sexual orientation, gender, nationality, or faith." In a 2021 profile by The Hollywood Reporter, Joanna became emotional when confronted with the couple's past controversies. Although she didn't address anything specifically, she said, "The accusations that get thrown at you, like you're a racist or you don't like people in the LGBTQ community, that's the stuff that really eats my lunch, because it's so far from who we really are." In 2017, Chip and Joanna Gaines announced a massive partnership deal with Target, which would include selling their exclusive Hearth & Hand line at affordable prices in the national chain.
And you see your line at Target, what do you think your reaction's gonna be?
Oh gosh, don't ask me.
Like, While many fans were excited to be able to bring some shiplap magic into their own home, others were vocal on social media about their disappointment in the Gaines partnering with Target, a company that has been vocal in its support for LGBTQA+ employees and customers. This support incited a backlash from religious conservatives, who perhaps interpreted the Gaines church affiliation with less tolerant views. The Gaines have denounced anti-LGBTQA+ views in general, but still have not directly addressed comments made by their church's pastor or the inclusivity policies of Target. As of this video, the Gaines continue to sell their home goods through the retailer. Many viewers flock to HGTV shows to get tips on how to perform their own home renovations, which is why the Environmental Protection Agency was quick to act when they discovered that Chip and Joanna Gaines were not safely removing lead paint during episodes of Fixer Upper. In a 2018 statement on its website, the EPA alleged, "Video footage of Magnolia's renovations of older homes appearing in several seasons of Fixer Upper reviewed by EPA did not depict the lead-safe work practices normally required by the renovation, remodeling, and painting rule." In the same statement, the EPA acknowledged that Magnolia quickly rectified the issue and paid a $40,000 fine set by the agency. The couple also spoke about the dangers of lead-based paint during a March 2018 episode of Fixer Upper and outlined steps that homeowners and professionals must take in order to ensure safe removal of the toxin. An additional video on the dangers on lead-based paint was also shared on Chip's Twitter page.
"Unfortunately, this old house tested positive for lead, so today we've all got to wear these groovy white suits."
Magnolia Homes even went above and beyond the steps outlined by the EPA. The company donated $160,000 to the Supplemental Environmental Project in Waco, Texas, which helped to ensure that homes, especially those built before 1978 and currently occupied by children, have lead-based paints removed safely by a third-party abatement team. We often find ourselves watching Fixer Upper and thinking two things. The first is that we would love our home to have the same welcoming aesthetic of all of the Magnolia Homes builds. The second is whether Joanna Gaines has considered launching a skincare line, because anyone who looks that effortlessly stunning while raising 5 kids, building an empire, and working in a construction zone has to have some great beauty secrets. Unfortunately, a scammer also took notice of Gaines' lack of wrinkles and capitalized on the opportunity by using the Magnolia founder's name. In 2017, Gaines was forced to take a break from sharing her latest designs and sweet family pics on Instagram to warn her fans about the scam. She wrote, "There have been rumors floating around about me leaving the show to start a skincare makeup line. I wanted to take a minute to let y'all know that it's simply not true. This is a scam. We have nothing to do with it and have been trying to stop it for some time." For the record, if Joanna Gaines does decide to launch an official beauty line, we'll take 2 of everything. Linda Evangelista once said she wouldn't get out of bed for less than $10,000 a day, and even with inflation, it appears the supermodel may have been undervaluing herself. In a 2018 legal case between Chip and Joanna Gaines, Magnolia Furniture, and one of their suppliers, Joanna listed her deposition fee at $150,000 per hour. That's a lot of shiplap. The massive fee was uncovered by Blast, which also noted that Gaines was neither a defendant nor a plaintiff in the case, making her massive fee even more shocking. Joanna was asked to be a part of the deposition since she was the one who discovered that the materials supplied for the furniture that was to be sold under the Magnolia Furniture name were not of the quality previously agreed upon. Gaines' high hourly fee appeared to be an effort on the Magnolia founder's part to be left out of the deposition. According to Blast, she had previously stated she would prefer to be part of the deposition only through written comments. Unfortunately for Joanna, a judge later ruled that not only did she have to sit for the deposition in person, she would also not receive her requested hourly rate. Maybe she should have started at $10,000 per day. Chip and Joanna Gaines were working on selling and renovating homes in the Waco area before HGTV cameras began rolling, but their level of success was significantly lower prior to their major TV deal. Before becoming household names, Chip was working with partners John L. Lewis and Richard L. Clark in the Magnolia Real Estate Company, which employed one agent. According to a 2017 lawsuit filed by Chip's former partners, Per People, the reality star bought out their shares of the company without disclosing that the show he and wife Joanna had been filming had been bought by HGTV. Chip's former partners filed a $1 million lawsuit against him, alleging that he bought their shares in the company for $5,000 without revealing that Fixer Upper had been greenlit by HGTV. Both Lewis and Clark told the media that after selling their shares to Chip, they didn't hear from their former partner again. Chip seemingly addressed the lawsuit and his former partner's claims in a tweet in April 2017, writing, "FYI, I've had the same cell number 15 years, same email for 20 years. No one called or emailed. 4 years later, friends reach out via lawsuit." Chip's lawyers argued that his former business partners were aware of the couple's deal with HGTV before selling their shares of Magnolia Realty. The records of the case have been sealed from public viewing, but we do know that in 2020, a Texas district court judge dismissed Lewis and Clark's lawsuit. In his 2017 best-selling memoir, Capital Gains, Smart Things I Learned Doing Stupid Stuff, Chip writes that a tweet from a customer alerting the Magnolia owner to a late shipment made him rethink whether the couple was able to handle all the projects they currently had in the works. Gaines explained, "I tried to shake it off, knowing that I couldn't do anything about it then and that it would have to wait until morning. No luck. I was up all night dwelling on it." Gaines was even prepared to walk off the set of Fixer Upper the following day so that he could go to the Magnolia warehouse and fix the issue himself. He said that the tweet sparked a conversation between him and Joanna, with the pair soon realizing they had taken on too many jobs. He wrote, "Suddenly filming the TV show looked like the job that had seduced me into giving it my precious time that I had always promised would be reserved for my true loves, my family, and my business. How had this side gig found its way to competing with the very things that mean more to me than anything else in the world?" In 2017, Chip and Joanna announced they would be ending their hit HGTV series after 5 seasons, in order to be able to give their family and their Magnolia furniture and design business the proper attention. Then parents to 4 kids, now 5, and filming 11 months of the year, it's understandable that the Gaines needed a break. But it was also rumored that the couple may have been upset by restrictions placed on them by HGTV. We now know that the Gaines have continued to build their TV empire through their own Magnolia Network on Discovery, and they've hopefully resolved any customer complaints they've been facing during their busiest time. Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite HGTV stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.